Hello students, in my previous video I have explained you a use of formula in Excel, use of function in Excel, what is relative reference and absolute reference through the Excel sheet file. Okay, today I will explain you few more topics like autosum, sorting, custom sorts, etc. Okay, now understand the first one, how to use autosum. Okay, how to use autosum. So what is autosum? Autosum function is used to sum a range of cells automatically. Means you can do a sum with the help of formula and function. You can also do a sum with the help of autosum option. Just click where you want to display the result. After that, click autosum option and choose sum option. Okay, now press enter key. Then you can see here is the result. Here is the total of the ankit marks. Okay, now use relative reference, drag it. Then formula will be copied in all other cells in F3, F4, F5 and so on. Okay, that is the use of autosum. Okay, understand? Now understand what is sorting. Sorting is the process of arranging data into meaningful order so that we can analyze it more effectively. Okay, means you can arrange your data alphabetical order, means from A to J or from Z to A, means in ascending order or descending order. In ascending order, you can arrange data alphabetically and numerically. Alphabetically means A to Z or Z to A, and numerically means from smallest to largest and largest to smallest. Okay, now see here, you can see at first place Ankit, second place Rahul, third place Shivani, fourth place Suraj, and then Jyoti, then Palak. Okay, I am going to apply a sorting on this column, so you will click on the header means here in this area of the column. Okay, and after that you will choose this option, sort and filter option. Click here and choose sort A to Z. Okay, after that click here, expand the selection, sort, look, Ankit, Jyoti, Palak, Rahul, Shivangi and Suraj. Again apply, click here and choose Z to A. Click sort, look, Suraj, Shivani, Rahul, Palak, Jyoti, Ankit. That is arranged in ascending and descending order. Okay, now how to arrange data numerically? So you will apply on this column, click on the top of the total marks column and arrange the data highest to lowest and lowest to highest. Click on the sort and filter option, choose smallest to largest. Look, now you can see 302 is the lowest marks and 376 is the highest mark. Okay, a lowest marks obtained by Shivani and highest marks or topper of the class is Palak. Okay, highest scorer is Palak and lowest scorer is Shivani. Got it? That is the use of sort. Understand? Okay, now understand what is the use of custom sorting. Suppose we want to add a new column here, insert, write the name of this column is section. Suppose that one is from 7th C, second student from 7th D, third student from 7th B, fourth one from 7th D, fifth one from 7th C. Okay, and last one from 7th A. Suppose that there is a four section. Now, if you want to arrange this data according to the section, means if you want to display a student of class 7th A, then 7th B, then 7th C, then 7th D. So first you select header of the section column, then click on the sort and filter option. Now see, there is no option to arrange this type of column. Look, you can arrange only A to Z or Z to A in this column, but you cannot arrange according to 7th A, 7th B, 7th C and 7th D. So how will you arrange? So in that case, you will use custom sort option. First you click here on the custom sort option. Okay. After that, you will click on here, sort option. Then it will ask where you want to apply your custom sort. Then I will choose, I want to apply on the section field. Then choose value. What? Custom. You want to arrange this data according to your custom list. So click on the custom list. Make your custom list. How you will make a custom list? First you will write 7th A, then comma, 7th B, then comma, seventh A, then enter key, then 7th B, then enter key, 7th C, then enter key, and 7th D. Okay, after that you will click on the add option. When you click on the add option, this will be add in the custom list here in the left side. See, look, can see 7th A, 7th B, 7th C and 7th D. That means that is created. Your custom list has created. You can see your custom list has created here. After that, you will click on the OK option. Then again click on the OK option and see here it will arrange. After clicking on the OK option, look. Look here, that is arranged according to 7th A, 7th C and 7th D. Why? Because there's no one student from class 7th B. Okay, so that is arranged. This type of arrangement is called custom arrangement. Okay, this list is called custom list, and it whole process is called custom sorting. Now the next topic, what is filter? A filter can be used to narrow down data in worksheet to view only selected records. Means you can separate the records. You can see only those records. Which record do you want to see? Means if you want to see only maths marks, then you can apply a filter. If you want to see the list of students who scores above 90 marks in maths, then you will see only those records who got above 90 marks in maths subjects, and other detail, other records will hide temporarily. That is the use of filter. Okay, now I'm going to choose how many students got above 90 marks in maths subject. Okay, so in that case, first you will click on the math section. Okay, after that you will click on the filter option. Now choose filter. Okay, after that you can see this symbol. This symbol means a filter is applied. Now choose the condition. What you want? You want to choose number list. Okay, here you can see equals, does not equal to, greater than or equal to, less than equal to. So many option has given here, and custom filter option also given here. Means if you want to apply your custom list, then you can use this option. Otherwise you can choose in between these option. Okay, I want to display the list of the students who got 90 and above 90 marks in maths, then I will choose greater than or equal to. Okay, here I will write here what 90 means. I want the list of students who got 90 and above 90 marks. Okay, now I'm going to click on the OK button. Then you will see only the name of Suraj, Palak and Jyoti, because only these three students got 90 marks in a math subject, so other details will be hide and only these records will be displayed. That is the use of filter. Now click on the OK button. Look here, you will see only three records. Okay, so that is the use of filter. Okay, you will see only selected records and other records will hide. That is the use of filter. You can apply a multiple filters here, means first select all, okay, make it as it is. After that, you can apply your multiple filters, means the list of students who got above 70 marks in Math, English and Science. Okay, display the list of all students who got 70 marks above 80 marks in all three subjects, in Math, English and Science. So one by one, you will apply the filters in all three subjects. Okay, apply the filters on the English and everyone. Okay, now choose your condition. In Maths, in English greater than 80, in Maths greater than 80, and Science greater than 80. So finally you can see three students are got above 80 marks in all three subjects. Okay, so in this way you can apply a multiple filters. Okay, one by one you will choose, you will apply the filters. Okay, if you want to apply also one filters in computer, so again click on the computer option and choose what greater than 80. Okay, then you will see only two students got above 80 marks in Math, English, Science and Computer. Clear? Now that is the use of multiple filters. One by one you can apply your filters on every column field. Here I applied a filter on the Math, English, Science and Computer. What? To display the list of those students who got 80 marks in each subject. So you can see only two students got 80 marks in each subject. Okay, now make it as it is. Okay, now the last topic of this chapter is conditional formatting. The difference between the filter and conditional formatting is, in the case of filter you will see only selected records and other records will hide. In the case of conditional formatting, you will highlight the selected records and other records will not hide. It will not highlight, means which records you want to highlight, that one you can highlight with a different colors and other records will stay on that worksheet. It will not hide. In the case of filter, selected records will display and other records will hide. But in the case of conditional formatting, selected records will display in highlighted form, means in a different color, and other will be displayed as it is. Okay, that is the use of conditional formatting. In your book, it has written अब कंडीशनल फॉर्मेटिंग अलाउ अस टू हाईलाइट ओनली दोज सेल्स दैट कंटेन्स डेटा दैट मीट्स गिवन कंडीशन. ओके नाउ अंडरस्टैंड दिस वन लाइव. आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्प्ले द लिस्ट ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स हु गॉट अबव 90 मार्क्स इन मैथ्स. ओके हाईलाइट नॉट डिस्प्ले हाईलाइट चूज दिस कॉलम. ओके आफ्टर दैट फॉर दिस यू हैव टू क्लिक ऑन द conditional formatting option. You can see here is the conditional formatting option. Click here. Now it will ask you highlight cells. Yes, I want to highlight this one. Okay, how? By rule. Which rule? I want a result greater than. Okay, click here. You want a result greater than 90. Click. Which color do you want to apply? Light red. You can change this option. Light red, yellow, green. Okay. I'm going to use a green color. After that, click on the OK button. Now, you can see those students got above 90 marks, that one will highlighted with a green color. Suraj got 96 marks, Palak 97 and Jyoti 94 marks. Okay, now you can choose also which students got lowest marks in a science. Okay, means below 80. Okay, how many students got below 80 marks in a science, then click on here. Choose conditional option, highlight cells and choose less than below 80 with a red color. Okay. Now see, only one student got below 80 marks in a science subject. So in that way, you can highlight the records, selected records. Okay. Now display the list of all students who got the result marks between 60 to 80 in English. 60 to 80 in English. Then click on the English column option. Choose conditional formatting rules. Choose in between option. First 60 to second 80. Which color you want to apply? I want to apply yellow. Choose yellow color and press OK. Now see, our two students Suraj and Shivani got marks in between 60 to 80. Other students got either above 80 or below 60. But only two students got two marks. Only two students got marks in between 60 to 80. That is the use of conditional formatting. Okay, clear? Any confusion? Okay, now if you want to clear the conditional formatting option, then again click here where on the header of the column choose conditional option, and here you will choose the clear rules from the selected or clear the rules from the entire. I want to choose to clear the conditional formatting from entire set, and choose the second one option, then conditional formatting will be removed from the Excel sheet. Okay, so that is the last topic that one has completed. So your chapter one has completed. In the case of any doubts, you are free to ask. Do all the activities at home to watch the video and do the practice at home. And in the case of any doubt, you are free to call me and message me. Okay, tomorrow I will give you the question and answer of chapter 2. Okay, have a good day.